Now the chain, in our kits, you're going to find a heavy duty one. It's difficult to cut on these 29 inch ones with the 41 tooth sprocket. Most of the time they mount right up to it without having to even take a link out. We'll see what happens. So I'm going to feed it from the top. Professionals would probably recommend taking the case off, but you're a half mechanic anyway, or half professional mechanic anyway, so ordering this kit. So we'll just do it like a semi-professional does, and you just walk each tooth of the sprocket through one at a time with the flat screwdriver. And we already pulled our, oh no, we didn't pull our clutch thing in yet, that's why it's, sometimes they're hard to feed through. Other ones go through easier. But the hardest part is the last one, fishing it out of the thing. It's going to want to get caught up in the bottom of the housing there. But with a flathead screwdriver, most of the time you can pull it through. Okay, so we've got enough. We'll just wrap it around the socket. Look at that. That's why I like the 29 inch bikes with the sprockets I sell in these kits. You don't have to buy a heavy duty chain cutter because the chain's usually the exact length. But if you do have to buy a chain cutter, Harbor Freight sells a good quality one for a reasonable price for less than 20 bucks. Okay, so now we've got it to where we're just going to add a tensioner in there, and the tensioner is going to be about right there, and then we're going to put the set screws in the tensioner and then finish up with the muffler. Set the rear axle. We've ran the chain through. When you cut a length of a chain, you actually are taking out two lengths, so you don't want to go too short. You want some slack in it. You want a little bit of slack to where you can fit the chain tensioner in there. Now the chain tensioner's purpose is to keep the slack and to keep the direction of the chain to your back drive sprocket. If that's not on there, if this thing's flopping around and just not, you're going to throw the chain off the drive sprocket without this. So keeping that in mind. And keeping in mind that all chains are going to stretch. There's different qualities of 415 chains. I only sell the best, the 415 heavy duty, because the 415 chain stretches out so much that it's not fun to use on a bike. You have to adjust it too many times, in my opinion. Whereas this chain, you adjust it once or twice when it's new, and you ride for months without having to worry about doing a little adjustment. So what we're going to do, we're going to make sure that everything's going to fit, that we're going to have plenty of room to adjust it along the months or years of riding, and we're going to make it to where it's solid. You're going to, with these tensioners, you got four bolts, plus we're going to finish it up with a set screw to make sure it doesn't cave into the spokes ever. But that right there is where we're going to have it. Now I've put two washers in this, fat washers on this side, just to shim it out to get that roller a little closer to the chain. Some tensioners you can put like this and the slot is slotted that way, but this one's the way it is, so we're gonna go ahead and just put it together and shim it out a couple washers to get it, to get that roller out to the chain level. Okay, so we're just gonna tighten this up as tight as we can get it. at a the lowest spot on the tensioner. And then with this chain tensioner system, well, you can just alternate bolts left and right, tightening down, and you can put a squeeze on these that will never loosen up and pull into your spokes. I get so many phone calls from people who didn't tighten these down good enough or had the kind with the two bolts, which they work, but just not as good as something like this does. So it's 12 on the inside, 14 on the outside. Now we're gonna, before we get it too tight, we're gonna pull it all the way back to where the chain is real snug. Now you want a new bike, you want a real snug chain. Everything's going to get knocked down just a hair. Your gears, the initial stretch is going to happen with the chain. You don't want it really, really tight, but you do want it snug where you can feel it, because it'll loosen up right away. So why run it loose when it's going to loosen up your first couple rides just slightly anyway? Okay, now the job of the roller is to roll it, try to get it centered as close as you can. Now this one, I tightened it up, it's a little bit bent over, which is just fine with the crescent wrench. Usually you want a couple of them up there, but one might do, but I'm gonna pull it back just a hair. Much, but that looks fine right there. Oh, here's a wrench. If you have any, doing any like Schwinn's with or slanted frames, you can go ahead and bend this with using this method to get the wheel to run straight. But anyway, the whole idea is to get it to where the wheel's running, hitting the middle, the wheel's holding it to where the chain's hitting the middle of the sprocket, and then we put a set screw or two in there to keep it from going into the spokes. Now that we've got the roller on, we're going to put a set screw in there. This is a self-tapper. This is going to ensure that this thing will never pull into the spokes here. For any reason, these won't get loosened up. Bam. We're ready to go to the muffler.